But then we check the ascendant of the Prashna chart.
Right.
Ascendant, the not the ascendant lord, the ascendant. The ascendant will tell me, okay, he's searching all this, but what is going on in his mind, basically? Okay. So it's very weird sometimes, you know, that people are searching. Like, suppose Sunday somebody comes, they're asking about. So then I check Sun. Suppose Sun is in the 10th house. Okay. Great, great placement for career, name, fame, success. But then it's very weird. Sometimes then I see that Moon is sitting in the ascendant. So that means what is happening? The person is wanting to have a shift in career, but why? Because he doesn't feel good while going to the office. So Moon is a very feeling-based planet. It controls emotions. So then I know why he wants to shift his company. Why he wants to go to a different place? Because he doesn't get that feel-good factor when he goes to the office. Or he may search that feel-good factor, because that is something which is going on in his head all the time. Oh, do I feel nice here? Are the people good? Do they treat me nicely? Moon is always very attention-seeking. So then we know, okay, the Day Lord is the Sun. Yes, the Sun has sent him to me, right? Because the Sun has given him the energy to see the sunrise today. That's why he's
Right.
alive. So that means that Sun is very important. Then Moon is in the ascendant. Now the next step is we check the ascendant Lord. So ascendant Lord means the ascendant Lord will tell me how much determination the person has, or how much is that question bugging him, or how much is he ready to work to make that happen. So sometimes I see, suppose Mars is the planet, and Mars is in 10th house, or it is exalted, or in the money houses, you know, very good for finances. But then I see the Lagnesh is somewhere in debility. That is like telling there's a big opportunity which is coming to you by dint of your karma. But you are like, okay, should I take this or not? You know, I don't know. It's good, but it doesn't seem good. Yeah, on the other hand, it's opposite sometimes. You know, the Day Lord is very badly placed somewhere, which means you have very difficult karma coming up. But the Lagnesh is very strong. You know, Lagnesh is in Digbal, or it's in exaltation, something like this. Then you are like, you know, no, I want to do it. I will make it happen anyways. You know, that kind of a flavor will come. And I have seen if there are natural malefics in the ascendant, then the things are very difficult. Why? Because malefics in the ascendant will give you either depression or anxiety, one of the two. Like Mars, Rahu, Ketu, they can give you anxiety, hyper anxiety, you know, anger, frustration, jealousy, envy, competition, you know, these kind of things. And Saturn will give you know, depression. Oh, you are not good at it, you can't do it, leave it, you could not, now also you cannot, you won't be able to do it ever.
Right.
So,
I want to say something here.
yes.
As you rightly mentioned that in a Prashna Kundli, these three things are very important. One is the Vara, the day lord. If it is a Friday, Saturday, or Sunday, the position of that Vara lord is very, very one thing. Second is the position of moon. Moon represents your mind, emotions, the question coming out of that, right? And the strength of the question or the area of the question is judged by the ascendant. These three things are like, it holds a great importance in our Prashna Kundli.
Reinstantiate what I said. So first we check the Day Lord. We first check which houses the Day Lord is ruling. That will give us the agenda. Okay, depending on your ascendant, okay, not moon chart, Lagna chart, okay. Suppose the planet is ruling your 7th house, then the inquiry is about marriage sometimes. Okay. Now the house where the Day Lord is placed will tell you where are you going to fulfill that agenda. So suppose the Day Lord rules 7th house, and the 7th lord is sitting in the 3rd. That means you are going on searching online medium, you know, like some online websites, matrimony websites. Okay. or you are, or if the day lord as the seventh lord is sitting in the fourth house, then some relatives from your mother's side, or maybe your mother is not, your mother is not agreeing to the person you want to marry, or something like this. These kind of things can happen. Or ninth lord, then the father can come. Or tenth lord, that because of career you have to stay different, separate. Okay. Then we check the ascendant. The ascendant, the first house, will tell the what is going on in the person's head. And then we check the lord of the ascendant, because that will tell how much strength you have to, or how much willpower, I would say, not strength. You have to, you want to make that happen, actually. Or how desperate you are to make that happen.
Right.
Yeah, so as I said, if sometimes the, and then also we need to check, once we understand the theme of the horoscope, then we must check, the next step is we need to check the Karakas. The Karakas are very important. So if the day lord is ruling the 10th house, we must check Mercury. Mercury is very crucial. Then Mercury can tell me, so suppose now there's a person who comes to me and says, tomorrow I have an interview. Okay. Okay, I have an interview at Google, Microsoft, and everything is done. It's only on tomorrow. Okay. So what should I do? And let us assume he comes to you on a Sunday. Let us assume like this. Then, and suppose then we see Sun, he's a Scorpio Lagna. Let us assume. And he, his Sun is the 10th Lord in Scorpio Lagna. Or he comes to you on a Friday, like today, but he's Capricorn Lagna. Then Venus is his 10th Lord. Something like this. Okay. So then you know 10th lord is Venus. Okay, so suppose then Venus is sitting in his third house. Okay, then that third house is that interview preparation, you know, he is busy in interview preparation. And then if Venus is like currently Venus is in Aries. Okay, it just entered Aries. So for Capricorn Lagna, where will Venus be? In his fourth house now. Okay, so that means he is going through his school material earlier. Was 4,000 for the school. Okay, and is Venus very happy there in Aries? Not so much, I guess. So that means he's panicking, he's impulsive, he wants to study everything in one night. It's like that. Okay, so then you know that, then you check the Karaka. Who is the Karaka for the 10th house? It is Mercury, of course. Then Mercury's placement. So currently what is happening? Mercury is retrograde. That definitely means that tomorrow when he will give the interview, they will ask him something which he knows, but he will not be able to say it. And then as soon as the exam is over, he will remember, this I knew, why did I not tell? In fact, the same thing has happened with one of my friends. He recently gave an exam for finance. And he was asked a question and he very confidently spoke it, which was actually wrong, actually. And after speaking, he realized, why did I say this? It was ulta bol diya, I spoke the opposite. And then the interviewer also said, oh, actually, you said the opposite. You know? And he said, oh, yeah, yes, sir, I'm very sorry. I just spoke the opposite. You know, this is not true. The other one is true, actually. So now, Mercury is retrograde. So therefore, some question or some comment you will make which you might regret later.
Right.
Or you may try to, but then that's how Mercury retrograde is. Once it goes direct, it's all your fault. Okay. Nobody is to be blamed, only you are the culprit. So then you don't have defense, you see. So then they will say, oh, but time is up. You spoke it wrong. You ulta bola. So it's over now. Okay. Now that does not mean he will fail in the interview necessarily. But one blunder he will do, at least one. So that is how you see the Karaka for that house, and you see where Mercury is placed. So if the day lord rules the 10th house and Mercury is the Karaka, so now if Mercury is in a bad shape, then it's saying it is, now why is Mercury the Karaka for the 10th house? Because Mercury is the significator of skill. So it's like saying if Mercury is badly placed in that horoscope, you will not be able to use your skill properly. And if Mercury is very well placed, then you can use your existing skills. You may not have that much skill, but whatever you have, you will use it very to the best possible capacity. And suppose, for example, the day lord is ruling which house? Maybe the seventh house. And then which planet you must check? You know, it is Jupiter you must check, and then you must check Venus.
Yes.
And then the next step is you have to understand what is the cultural upbringing of that person.
Right.
That is gold. If you miss that, you have missed it. Why? Because let's take seventh house for example. If somebody is in a very traditional religious background, and then you don't have to see Venus for that. If the day lord rules seventh house, you only have to check Jupiter. But if somebody is born in a ultra modern family where you know everything is good, ye bhi theek hai, wo bhi theek hai, sab theek hai, then why to see Jupiter? There is no custom, there is no tradition which has been followed. Do whatever you want. So then, what do I want out of the marriage? I just want the pleasure of the opposite sex or the spouse or you know enjoyment, food and all these things. Then just check Venus. And then I also check the lords of the trines. The trinal lords will tell you to what extent it is helping the horoscope. Yeah, and the trines are always positive. The trinal lords are always there, always benefits. I mean, not always, they can also rule Dustana sometimes. But in general, they always help the horoscope. And if you have special planets, like if you have a planet in Digbala, you must check that. So suppose your day lord is Venus, and Venus is not having anything to do with the carrier houses. Okay. But then if you have this Mars in 10th house, so it is like a tusk which is going on.
Mm-hmm.
Venus is asking about marriage, suppose, and then this Mars is, you know, pulling to the 10th house. So then you have to inform the person that, okay, my dear sir, you might get married, of course, no problem. But because of career, the pull is so much that your marriage may be delayed because of that. Or the thumb rule of Jyotish, if Saturn is there, then it's or if a retrograde planet is there, then second attempt is must. In first attempt, it never happens. Retrograde means at least one more attempt. Whoa, mandatory. That is mandatory. So if the day lord is only retrograde, then the challenge is more. Because then it's like saying the whole thing you have to do it twice. That's a big task. And then if the question is how do we solve the problem? So suppose we see that things are not very good. Then we try to check how can we strengthen those planets which are giving that result. So for example, if somebody is asking question pertaining to 10th house, or the day lord rules the 10th. So now it's very weird sometimes. It can happen. I have seen this happening. The person will come and ask you, sir, when I will get married. So you will think, oh, okay, we need to check 7th house, Venus. And okay, it's done actually. We will finish it very fast. But then it's very weird. The person comes to you on a Wednesday and the person is maybe a Sagittarius rising. And then Mercury is ruling the 10th house. So then you are like, okay, so Mercury also rules the 7th. It also rules the 10th. And generally these two houses are not in harmony always. Marriage and career.
Right.
More than the other is always going down. Then how do you see what to do? So then you have to see the Mool Trikon Rashi is where. Because only sun and moon will have one sign.
Mm-hmm.
All the other planets will rule two houses.
Mm-hmm.
Then you check where is the Mool Trikon Rashi. So for example, if a Sagittarius rising is asking a question on Wednesday, then Mool Trikon sign of Mercury is the 10th house, Virgo.
Mm-hmm.
So now it's very weird. The person is not interested in 10th house. He's only asking, when will I get married? how do you solve this question? Well, actually what is happening, then maybe the ascendant is having some link with the seventh lord. because that is always going on in his head 24 hours. Marriage, 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 marriage.
But Prashna will show that.
Yeah, yeah, but because the day lord is ruling the 10th house as the Mool Trikon Rasi, the marriage is getting delayed because of the 10th house. So you should not always trust the client what he's saying in face value. If you think, oh, 7th house, okay, 10th house, forget it, no, not required. Then you have done the biggest blunder. You have taken, your first step is only wrong. You have made the blunder in the first step. You are going on analyzing everything and you are not checking where Mercury is. Or as I said, you know, Capricorn Lagna, Friday, 10th Lord Venus, and he's asking you, when will I get married? So then what do you do? Okay, Capricorn Lagna, Moon is the 7th Lord. Okay, where is Moon? I check that. Mm-hmm, interesting. But no, if he's on here on a Friday, then the first question has to be related to the 10th house, because Venus for Capricorn rules two houses, 5th and the 10th. But Libra is Mool Trikon, that is the 10th house. So that means you have to counter question the client. You have to ask him, sir, what about your career? What's happening there? Then he will start telling, oh, actually, you know, one proposal came, but I was here, she was there, this is not happening. And then you understand where what is the starting point. Then you know from because of which house the challenge is coming, first of all.
Right.
And then sometimes the 9th house is there. So you have to kind of see what is happening. And then 9th house Karaka is Jupiter. And then you have to see, is it a guru or a father? If guru, then Jupiter. If father, then it's the sun. So then this is how you finally come to a conclusion. It's like reading a normal birth chart only. It is not some exceptional, and there is no some exceptional. Although there are many rules given in the classics, like for example, they check the placement of the moon. They say if moon is in the Kendra, that means that thing is going to come very quickly. Now I always respect the classics, and I have nothing against it. But in my opinion, I think people have applied these very literally. Because there are many things. Sometimes if suppose somebody is asking you when they will get married and you see moon is in the 7th. But if you use the concept of Bhav Chalit, if it is behind the ascendant's degree, it is in the 6th house.
Right.
So then you have made a big blunder. You see, you tell that, the person is going to get married. And then after 1 month, the person is like, sir, you said, abhi 10 din mein shaadi hoga mera, kidhar, koi nahi mil raha, ek mahina ho gaya. So it's all the different ways. So to summarize, first you check the day lord, the house's rule, then the placement and the planets conjunct. I did not speak about this. So let me say about this. So if suppose the person is, if the day lord is ruling the 5th house, for example, so then that means the inquiry is primarily about childbirth, if the couple is married, of course. And then if suppose, let's take any example. Let's take Scorpio rising, for example. Then Jupiter becomes the second and the 5th lord.
Right.
Now, if suppose Jupiter, so suppose somebody asks this question after 7th April. Because that time Jupiter, Venus, Saturn will be conjunct in Capricorn.
Yes.
7th April, around that time. So now what? The day lord, the day is also Jupiter, and he's ruling the second of it, but he's conjunct this Saturn in Capricorn. So then that means there is going to be a lot of delay by default. Even if the 5th lord is exalted, there will still be delay because the day lord is with Saturn. Because if you see, why do I stress about Saturn? Not just because he's Saturn, he's the bad guy, you know, he's the late guy. No, not because of that. If you check the system of the day, who is the initial giver? It's the sun, right? So, which is the last day from the sun? It is Saturday. Okay, and I have tried to use this for various methodologies, and it works perfectly, I have seen. So, for example, somebody is asking you a question about let's take the example of Mercury, or so let's take Thursday, Jupiter's example. So in that planet, in that prasna, if somehow Mercury gets a very prominent role as the Lagnesh or the Day Lord, then the outcome is not very good if it is related to Jupiter, because Mercury is the it is the sixth day, you know, or you could say the last day from Thursday is Wednesday. Similar is if the question is pertaining to marriage.
Mm-hmm.
And marriage, again, the modern marriage, okay, not the traditional marriage. Then, then if somehow Jupiter is playing a very important role, he's in Lagna, or, you know, he's the Day Lord, or these kind, or he's ruling the seventh, and the question is pertaining to marriage, then it could happen that there is again some delay. Because the planet which is ending you, so Friday's ending is Thursday. That planet has become very powerful.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like saying he's eating up a lot of time and space from the horoscope. Yeah, so it's like that. So for Saturday, if the person is asking you, sir, I want to go to Haridwar and do some tapasya and be in seclusion, loneliness, no mobile, nothing. And then you see Venus is sitting in the ascendant.
Mm-hmm.
You know it's going to be a problem there. Because Saturday is end, you know, Friday is the ending day of Saturday. So, you know that instead of doing tapasya, the person might go and indulge in doing bhog vilas there, which is Venus. Yeah, and so somebody is asking about Sun, you know, like name, fame, power, position. And then Saturn is the most prominent planet. Saturn is poverty. So there you see. Sunday, Saturday, Friday, Thursday, then